What is up, you guys? You're watching Sergio's Secrets. Before I get started with today's video, if you can please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe button. I post Monday through Friday in the month of March, so make sure to subscribe to notice any one of my uploads. And today, we are reviewing Kurt Geiger handbags. Now, this has been something that has been highly requested on my channel, is to talk about Kurt Geiger handbags. Now, I personally don't own any, but I have some friends that do own, and I asked if they can lend me their handbags while I film a video about Kurt Geiger. I asked their thoughts, I asked their opinions, and for me, like, what do I think of Kurt Geiger handbags? So let's go ahead and get started. So Kurt Geiger, I feel like within the last 2 years, have really made its way into the United States. It's not a brand that I heard about before, prior 2 years ago, and a lot more department stores are starting to carry their items, from footwear and kind of small leather goods and handbags. So it is kind of a newer brand. But what I will say is, when I was in London about a month ago, I'll just the footage here, a lot of people carried Kurt Geiger bags. It was kind of like their kind of their popular handbag that a lot of people carry. And I saw the conditions of some of them. I went to the stores, I felt and I touched a lot of their newer collections, or what the shoes, how they felt in quality. So I already have a nice understanding of Kurt Geiger handbags. I am here to give you an honest review of Kurt Geiger bags, because, you know, I am somebody that's really honest and I like to be really transparent, because all of us work really hard for, you know, all the things that we have. Go ahead and get started with Kurt Geiger. So, like I said, Kurt Geiger does shoes. I will not be talking about shoes. I will be mainly talking about their handbag experiences. So, what makes Kurt Geiger, or what differentiates them from other contemporary brands? And for me, it is their uniqueness. A lot of Kurt Geiger bags have fun prints, have fun styles. Like this one has, you know, little jewels on here. It's snakeskin print. It has gold hardware. Or you have this really fun, you know, not for everybody, but this really fun rainbow bag that has, you know, little bird with these little crystal details with the hardware. Like, a lot of Kurt Geiger's known for having a lot of novelty bags and a lot of kind of fun bags. They do have core styles. They do have clean cut classics, kind of like this gray color right here. But for the most part, I would say like maybe 60 to 70% of their bags are going to be more of kind of like these kind of funner type style novelty bags. I will be talking about the core bags first, and then we'll go into kind of more of the funner bags. So the core bags have this style right here. It is lambskin leather, I believe. But when you feel it, it feels very kind of soft and nice to the touch. But what I will say, and what my friend said when she was carrying this bag, is she said that this is a nice bag, but the thing is, this is not going to be a durable bag. So if you're somebody that throws around your bag, if you're somebody that, you know, is used to kind of Coach bags, that, you know, you always throw them around, they always hold up really nice and really well, or your Troy Burch Robinson toe, or, you know, stuff like that. You know, if you are used to kind of rough handling your bags, this is not going to be a bag for you. This bag, it's a pretty bag, it's really nice, it's very sleek, it's very stylish, but it is a lot more delicate. If you feel it, the leather is a little bit thin, I will say that. Not necessarily a bad thing, but I could feel like this bag could be easily kind of misshaped in. It can easily lose its kind of shape of it. The back, it looks like the car, like it just feels kind of thin. It feels a little bit more delicate, so I would not recommend this bag, especially if you're not really delicate or you really take care of your bags. So even for myself, I probably wouldn't go for a style like this, and this goes for the backpacks as well. Anything with kind of this soft leather, I would highly avoid to kind of using them on the daily basis, even their small leather goods, just because the small leather goods, like the wallets and the card holders, you use those a lot more. So therefore, they're going to be showing wear a lot more. I've seen wears in the corners. I just seen these bags like in the UK, they just don't necessarily wear really well. If you're considering buying these bags, this kind of lambskinny type soft bags, I would just suggest that you just be a little bit more careful with it, and I wouldn't treat it like your, you know, your traditional Coach bags or your Dooney & Burke bags or your Longchamp bags. I would take a little bit more caution with these bags, just because they are a little bit more delicate. Now, as far as these kind of like the chevron, I do like the birds with these kind of little crystal little embellishments on there. I do like the chain. The chain, it feels very hollow, but not necessarily in a bad way. It's a very nice, like I said, it's a nice lightweight bag. That's why the leather is really thin on it. So I would just recommend, if you're looking to purchase Kurt Geiger handbags, if you're a little bit more hard on your bags, I would probably stay away if you're planning to use it as a everyday handbag. So That goes for the core kind of styles, like the black ones and anything kind of like in the soft leather if you're planning to use it every day. Now, I'm also going to be talking about the tote because I know somebody who's had the tote since Kurt Geiger started really making their move in the US, which is this one right here. It is made in Italy. It is a nice everyday tote. This one, I have not heard anything negative about this bag. I've only heard really positive things. It is a tote under $300 that is made in Italy. The leather's really nice. It's really supple. It fits a lot. I do really like this tote a lot and recommending the tote. Now, like I said, if any of you guys have any experiences with Kurt Geiger bags, I would definitely love to hear your feedback down below. So that is kind of all the core styles. Now we'll be talking about the novelty styles. So the novelty styles are more like the rainbow one, this one, the tweed bags, like all those stuff. I really do like them. They make an outfit pop, you know what I mean? If I'm wearing kind of like a white blazer and I'm wearing black trousers and, you know, just a simple shoe and I put on this bag, it just makes everything pop. It makes everything so elevated. That's what I like about Kurt Geiger bags. It's just, they just make any outfit, take it to the top notch. If you don't want to spend, you know, a lot of money on designer handbags or like even like novelty designer handbags, like a lot of my handbags that I have in the designer section are going to be more kind of clean cut, basic, more styles, just because I'm investing a lot of money in, so I want to wear them a lot. But what I like about Kurt Geiger is they're, you know, yes, they're pricey because they are technically contemporary bags, but for under $300, under $200, you get a lot of that kind of fun designer look without spending a lot of money, if you know what I mean. Like, right now in my life, I don't see myself buying like a novelty Jimmy Choo bag or a novelty Louis Vuitton bag or a novelty Chanel bag. I just don't see myself doing that because I'd rather buy a clean cut core style. So having these kind of in place would be a really great one. And that's what I see in a lot of editorial shots. That's what I see like a lot of my friends wear. I'm planning to purchase a Kurt Geiger bag any day now. I'm still deciding on certain styles, but I do see myself adding one. And that's what a lot of the girls in London, they had a very simple style. A white blouse, a black trousers, you put this on and it kind of makes any outfit kind of go. And that's what I like. You know, some of them may be a little bit more out there, like this rainbow bag, but there are a lot of different variations of the novelty styles. There's smaller bags, there are bigger bags. They came out with like tweed bags. Like they have some that are kind of made out of that kind of straw material. There's so much variety in the novelty sector of the Kurt Geiger bags. And when I mean novelty, I don't mean like it's a bad thing. I just feel like novelty, like they go with your outfit. You can use them for the season. You know, they're just nice kind of on-trend bags. And they're like, look how beautiful this is. This is actually really adorable. So I do really like a lot of the novelty bags, and also you won't be wearing them every single day, a lot of the novelty styles, just because they may clash with certain things. Like I wouldn't wear these two because they will clash, or this will clash. I will wear this if I'm wearing more simple outfits. So for me, like as me, somebody having like designer bags, more contemporary bags, I feel like these are bags that, you know, you will be using with certain outfits, but they're really great. And I personally really like a lot of the Kurt Geiger novelty bags. And that is going to be kind of my review on the Kurt Geiger. I would not really recommend these bags if you're going to be using them consistently every single day. If you're going to drug them through the mud, the tote is fine, but everything else, I would probably highly not recommend that, just because yes, they're made well, they're made decent, they're not made to be worn every single day, especially like this one. Like I can see this one getting really beat up in like 30 days and it looks kind of trash. Like even you can see, like my friend has this bag and you can even see like the little leather is kind of nicking off. I don't know if you guys can kind of tell. It is kind of right there with the little leather. So like I said, I wouldn't recommend Kurt Geiger bags for every day except the tote. But if you are looking for a bag to go with your outfit, if you're looking back to, you know, wear for a season or wear for a vacation or wear for this and that, I definitely recommend them. I think they're nice, they're fun bags, they're different, you know what I mean? Kurt Geiger has not even been in the States for that long, so it is something new. A lot of people don't even know who Kurt Geiger is. That's why I decided to make a handbag review. I do really like the novelty. I really like them. I think they're so much fun. There's so much color. You can try different colored bags without spending a lot of money. And so for me, I'm definitely going to be recommending Kurt Geiger bags. I would not be recommending the kind of classic bags, just because I feel like I wouldn't wear this, and if I want a classic bag, I already have classic bags in my collection, so there's really no point of having like classic bags. But if you do want like a novelty like this, like I said, how I would wear it, like a silk blouse, some black slacks, a nice little fur that you throw on this, like, you look super editorial, you look super polished, you look super it. So for me, like, I do like a lot of the novelty bags, and that's what, if I were to purchase Kurt Geiger bags, which I probably do see myself purchasing a Kurt Geiger bag in the near future, I just feel like they are more like to go with certain outfits or for this and that, and they're kind of vibes. Like, each bag has a different vibe to them. Like, this is more like, oh my god, out there, like, in your face. I personally would not wear this one, but this one I definitely would wear. Like, this is my vibe. Snakeskin, like, imagine wearing like a crisp clean shirt with like nice jewelry, like, you know what I mean? It's just kind of a vibe when you wear a lot of the Kurt Geiger bags, if you know what I mean. So yes guys, Sergio's Secret is going to be approving all Kurt Geiger novelty bags, be approving the core styles, just because I am someone that's really rough on my items, or not even rough, but that just uses them consistently. So I see them having wear in the long run, so that's not something that I'm willing to spend, even if it's under $500. That's a lot of money that is just gonna, if it's gonna get a lot of wear and it's gonna look like it's not gonna wear the best. But yeah guys, novelty Kurt Geiger, yes. The Kurt Geiger tote is a yes. Core styles, like the flap ones that are like lambskin leather, unless you're wearing them like every once in a while or not every day, or you take really great care of your bags, I think that's fine. But like, I know like a lot of my subscribers, a lot of my followers, they use their bags almost every single day, and then they also have those bags that they bring out. So yeah guys, this is gonna be my little review on Kurt Geiger. I would definitely love to hear your feedbacks and your comments down below. I know I have some subbies that are from the UK, and I would love to hear your thoughts down below on Kurt Geiger. Like I said, I saw a lot of people having them in the UK. There was a store in at the Heathrow Airport that had a little section in Selfridges. Like, Kurt Geiger was really popular, so I want to hear your thoughts down below. Like, who is the Kurt Geiger girl? Who is the Kurt Geiger boy? I would definitely love to hear that in the comment sections down below. And yeah guys, thank you so much for watching this Kurt Geiger review, and I'll see you guys on the next one. And let me guys know if you want to see any other reviews on my channel. Like, let me know down below, and I'll be happy to film those videos. And this is Sergio's Secrets, and thank you so much for watching my video, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Bye guys.